This is Jameson with Cooper Fleet Services. Today is July 2nd, 2021, and this is recent automotive news. Most dealers are reporting inventory level day supply in the low 30s. In my experience, I've traditionally seen averages closer to 90 to 100 day supply at dealerships. This is getting quite dire, even as many of the auto manufacturers post double-digit gains for June and quarter two. With no end in sight, the US auto manufacturers announced more delays and cancellations. We decided to get you footage from downtown Detroit so you can see the current situation for yourself. I also think we have a message from the executive leadership in the auto industry.
This is fine.
With jokes aside, I know that this will be affecting many people's livelihoods, and for me, the biggest issue is the lack of trust in what the large auto manufacturers say. It seems to me, instead of preparing their partners for the reality of what's to come, they seem much more worried about keeping up appearances and stock prices. The UAW announced that Ray Curry, the previous secretary treasurer, was elected as the president of the union. This comes after previous UAW president Rory Gamble announced his retirement effective June 30th this year. Rory breaks the UAW streak of having ex-presidents indicted for corruption and fraud charges, and hopefully this is a good direction for the union that has been plagued by executive misconduct. Do you know how many wrecks are caused by advanced driver assist technology and automated driving? Me neither, and neither does the NHTSA. I was shocked to find out that wrecks caused by automated driving systems and advanced driver assistance technology did not have to submit crash reports until recent changes. The NHTSA is now requiring manufacturers and drivers to send mandatory crash reports when an advanced system is engaged during or directly before an accident. Audi will be selling EVs directly to consumers in Europe in 2023. The dealers will act only as intermediaries under what they call the agency model. Audi is currently telling its dealerships that they are the backbone of their operation, but they are making these changes based on the changing buying habits of their customer base. The big three automakers in Detroit and the UAW will be lifting their mask mandate for vaccinated workers. Workers will not have to show proof of vaccination to remove the mask, and this will be effective on July 12th. GM and BrightDrop will be pursuing production of their EV600 electric delivery van earlier than expected. GM's plant in Ingersoll, Ontario, as of April 2022, will no longer produce the Equinox, and it will be the main production of the new electric vehicle from GM. A German court rejected a bid put forth by a couple of environmental groups in Europe over Tesla's new gigafactory outside of Berlin. These groups were worried about the pollution and possible water contamination from battery production. The court found no evidence that hazard would arise. With production delays and problems with changing regulations, Tesla is unsure when the launch date will be for the new site. That's been it for automotive news this week. If you like content like this, please check out our website at www.cooperfleetservices.com. If you would, leave a like and a comment down below. It really helps us out. Hope you all have a wonderful 4th of July weekend and stay safe. Thanks.